Good morning. Welcome you on this day as we continue to hear the parables of Jesus. Today we think about what it means to be wheat and weeds, what it means to be bearing good fruit, and what it means to deal with the evil and the sin among us and within us. Mad Camp is scheduled for August 10th through the 14th. You can get the registration form from the emailer or from your bulletin and contact Janice about that. We'll be meeting shortly to decide how we're going to conduct Sunday school, confirmation, Bible studies, and First Communion classes this year, so stay tuned for that. The worship at the Borough Park has been canceled for this year. Due to the pandemic, we are unable to have breakfast, so we'll continue with our worship in the back parking lot. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, we extend our sincere Christian sympathy to the family and friends of Jean Hoffert, who died on July 13th. There will be a graveside service for Jean Monday at 11 a.m. at Hope Cemetery in Hecktown. Now it's time to draw the time to sing hymn for next week. The hymn will be number 422, For All the Saints. For All the Saints. That's a good one to begin with. And now it's time for our time to sing hymn for today, I Am the Bread of Life, hymn 485. We sing today. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Faithful God, most merciful Judge, you care for your children with firmness and compassion. By your Spirit, nurture us who live in your kingdom, that we may be rooted in the way of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
A reading from Romans. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If, in fact, we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forevermore. teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth.
For great is your love toward me. You have delivered me from the pit of death. The arrogant rise up against me, O God, and a band of violent people seeks my life. They have not set you before their eyes. But you, O Lord, are gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and full of kindness and truth. Turn to me and have mercy on me. Give your strength to your servant and save the child of your handmaid. Show me a sign of your favor so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame. Because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
Teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth.
Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 13th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field, but while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, An enemy has done this. The slave said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at the harvest time, I will tell the reaper, collect the weeds first, and bind them in bundles to be burned. But gather the wheat into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house, and his disciples approached him, saying, Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field. Jesus answered, The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous shall shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. It's so dramatic, isn't it? They find out there's weeds growing. Master, didn't you plant good seed? And the master says, An enemy has done this. You can just see it, right? Like some music building, dum, 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 boom, an enemy has done this. So dramatic. And right away, those servants, they see that the weeds are coming up. They see that the wheat is coming up. And they just want to jump in. Shall we gather them? Shall we go rip them up, master? Shall we pull them all out? We just want to jump in there, right? Get to work. Figure out what's good, what's bad. Get rid of it. Did you hear the story about Daniel Maples? In late June, he was in a Costco in Fort Myers, Florida. Now, he was supposed to be wearing a mask, but he didn't wear a mask. and he went in to the store. And while he was in the store, according to him, people started harassing him about not wearing a mask. They came up to him and said, "I have cancer, I have cancer." And he didn't know, he said, my father had cancer. And people started gathering around him. And finally, somebody pulls out a phone and starts to record him. And this is what we've seen, this video of this man losing it. He's clenching his fists. He's coming towards a person who's filming, saying, "I feel threatened," but he seems very threatening himself. A filmmaker took this 20 seconds of this man's life and posted it on the internet. Now something like 20 million people have seen it. Unbelievable. What happens next? His employer finds out. He loses his job. People find out his name and his address and his phone number, and they post it all over the internet. He starts getting texts and mail and email with threats and death threats. And they're even threatening his son's life. "Let's get him. Let's jump on him. Pull it out. Root it up." Very dramatic. But that's how we are today, right? We just want to jump on it. Pull it out. Forget it. Ruin this man's life. Haven't you ever lost it? Haven't you ever lost your temper? Boy, I know I have. When my kids were little, we had puppies. And you know puppies, right? They have to go every 10 seconds. And you take them out, and they go, and they come back in, and they go, and there's a puddle on the floor, and the kids are at the table eating breakfast, and there's the puddle on the floor. And I say to the kids, "There's the puddle on the floor. Do you see the puddle?" "Yes, we see the puddle." "When you get up from breakfast, don't step in the puddle. I can't clean it up right now. Don't step in the puddle." "Okay." So they get up and they step in the puddle. And I lose it. "Did you see? You saw it?" Boy, if that had been filmed, if that had been posted across the internet, my life might have been ruined. I'm sure you've lost it. You've yelled things, said things you didn't want to say, didn't mean to say. You punched a wall or kicked something. We've all done it. We've all been there. But we want to jump on that, right? Today, when we see things like that, when we see things like that that cross us somehow, let's send him a death threat. Let's send him emails. Let's threaten his son. That'll teach him. Well, we can't have this guy working for us anymore. It's too much of a liability. Nobody would want to buy insurance from us if he's still working for us. What are we supposed to do? His behavior is inexcusable. He should have been wearing a mask. His behavior when he lost his temper is inexcusable. He shouldn't have done that, but he did. What are we to do? The landowner says to his slaves, "Let them be. Let them be." Because when you start ripping up the wheat and you start ripping up the weeds, you're gonna ruin everything. You'll pull up some of the good along with the bad. Let them be. Permit them to grow together. Forgive them. Now in the end, it'll all be sorted out. I'll have wheat for my barn and I'll have kindling for my furnace where the weeds will be burned up. But let them be. Let them grow alongside one another for now. Nelson Mandela was elected president of South Africa in 1994. He was the first African to be elected in a fully democratic election in that country. He'd fought against apartheid, the system that separated the races from one another, the system that kept the darkest people down and the lightest people up, the system that favored the whites and the blacks were left behind. He fought against that. He fought against it, and finally he was arrested, and he spent decades in jail. And while he was in jail, he continued to work for equality, that the black prisoners received the same treatment as the white prisoners. He continued to speak to his jailers, And yet many of them tortured him, belittled him, beat him. When he was elected president, the story goes that he and his security team went to a restaurant and they ordered their food and they sat down and were talking to one another, and there on at another table is a man. And he says to his security team, go and invite that man to come over and sit with us. And so the man comes over and sits quietly. Finally, the food comes. They enjoy their food. The man eats his food, but with trembling hands, saying nothing, and then he leaves. The security guards say, what was that? Who was that man? Was he sick? Is that why he's trembling so much? Mandela said, no, that was one of my jailers, one who tortured me. I invited him to come over and eat with us because we must be forgiving. We must be compassionate. He endured such suffering at the hands of his jailers. And yet, he lets them be. And yet, when he takes power in the country, he doesn't drive white people into the sea, but he sets up a reconciliation board so that the races can come together and work together as a nation in South Africa. He lets them be. God will sort it out in the end. He doesn't turn away from the evil. He doesn't pretend like it doesn't exist. But he knows that love and mercy, compassion and forgiveness will get him much more than revenge and violence. In our own lives, we do not put our hope in ourselves. We do not put our hope in the way that we often react to situations that are thrown at us, situations that maybe we cannot manage, anxiety that is through the roof, tension and stress that is difficult to manage. We do not put our faith in ourselves and our reactions that we have to others around us or the way that people react to us and the way that we might be treated to others who would pick up violence or who would be stressed out or filled with anxiety and maybe not at their best. We have a deeper reality. Reality of a God who comes to us in the person of Jesus Christ, who continues to show compassion and forgiveness and love, who lets them be. God will sort it out in the end. But in the meantime, Jesus lives among us, loves us, goes to the cross still loving us, letting them be. And the powers, the evil, the sin is defeated. Because Jesus lives, he continues to love us. In this, we place our hope that we have been called God's children. Even when we lose it, even when we act out in sin, even when we are even evil, we are still God's children. And the one across from you is God's child, one to be loved. A family bought a house. And the kingdom of God can be compared to their new expansive lawn with beautiful grass, but also with weeds. And the family calls a landscaper and says, what weed killer should we use to get rid of these weeds? And the landscaper says, none. Water the lawn, aerate the lawn, fertilize the lawn, mow the lawn, and the grass will grow and choke out the weeds. Amen.
Will soon be free in the cold and snow of winter.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Take a moment to share the peace with those around you. If you're watching this home alone, think about someone you can share the peace of Christ with today, someone who needs to hear words of compassion and forgiveness and love. This is the time when we normally collect our offerings. I continue to thank you for your generosity as our ministries here continue, as we look to the fall programming and continue with Sunday school and confirmation and First Communion and Bible studies and the ways that we'll need to do that during the pandemic. I thank you for supporting our ministries that we have here at this church. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Confident of your care and helped by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God of the harvest, you sow the good seed of the gospel of Jesus Christ into your field. Help your church throughout the world to be both diligent and patient, full of resolve and gentleness, that our witness may be faithful to your intentions. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all space and time, your whole creation groans in labor pains, awaiting the gift of new birth. Renew the earth, sky, and sea, so that all your creation experiences freedom from the bondage of decay. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of the nations, teach us your ways, that we may walk in your truth. Mend the fabric of human family, now torn apart by our fearful and warring ways. Guide us by your mercy, grace, and steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of hope, you accompany those who suffer and are near to the brokenhearted. Open our hearts to your children who are lonely and abandoned, who feel trapped by despair, and all who suffer in any way. Especially we pray for our nation as we continue to face this pandemic. Open our hearts in love, O God, to the least of these among us. Give us a heart of sacrificial love, of sacrificial service, that we may get through this pandemic together. We pray, O God, for those essential workers in hospitals, emergency rooms, grocery stores, those who pick up our garbage, deliver our goods. We pray for those who suffer from the illness of COVID-19. We pray for those in hospitals and ICUs. We pray for those families who mourn the loss of loved ones. We also pray, O God, for those we know among us who are in need of prayer, especially Karen, Cliff, Linda, Floyd, Donna, Linda, James and Peggy, Joy, Clint, Louisa, Jane, Renata, Carl, Michael, Connie, Mary, Jack, Stephen, Keith and Sandra, JC, Ronald, Rich, and all those we now name in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of the seasons, in the midst of this summer, give us refreshment, renewal, and new opportunities. We pray for the safety of those who travel. We pray for those who cannot take the rest they need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of love, you have loved us through your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray, O God, that as we rest in that love, as we call you our Abba, may we show love to others as we bear the good fruit of the kingdom of compassion and forgiveness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of life, those who have died in you shine like the sun in your endless kingdom. We remember with thanksgiving the saints of all times and places and saints close to us, especially Jean Hoffert. Gather us with them on the day of salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the sure and certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. On this day, we wish to extend farewell and Godspeed to Judy Marola, who is moving to State College, right? You want to come up here, Judy? She's been a faithful member of this church since birth. Yeah. And we certainly will miss her. We want to wish her God's blessings as she journeys. Judy, as you leave our congregation, we wish to bid you farewell. A reading from Exodus. The Lord said, I'm going to send an angel in front of you to guard you on the way and to bring you to the place that I have prepared. In holy baptism, our Lord Jesus Christ received you and made you a member of this church. When you came to this congregation, we rejoiced to welcome you into the mission we share as the people of God. In this community, you have come to know and to share in God's loving purpose for you and for all creation. God has blessed you in this community, and God has blessed us through you. We encourage you to continue to receive and share God's gifts in whatever congregation God leads you to, united with us in the body of Christ and the mission we share. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for Judy and for the time we have shared with her. As she has been a blessing to us, so now send her forth to be a blessing to others. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor. And in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, give you peace. Amen. Godspeed. Thank you. in peace. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.